Beautiful. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another episode of Hoosierback Outdoors. There's this thing around here we have in southern Indiana. It's a rock. It's called a geode. What it actually is a big chunk of quartz. And today we're going to head up to a spot where I know there's some at. I'm going to get one, and we're going to bust it open and see what it's like. So stay tuned. Oh yeah, and before I forget, another thing I wanted to mention. If you've joined us today and you like this kind of content, smash that subscribe button. It would be very much appreciated. Now, let's get on the road. Spot, and I'm fixing to head up this hill over here where I know there's some geodes. We are up here at Lake Monroe, and there's a hillside right over here that I know there's tons of geodes. Our geodes here are more of the sedimentary form. In other words, let me explain this to you real quick while I'm headed up this hill. Geodes are most commonly formed when magma is cooled super fast. Seeing that we don't have any volcanoes here, what we've got in this part of the country is sedimentary geodes, which is formed over a long period of time when layers of sediment are formed upon top of each other, and there will be a space created by organic material such as wood, grass, impurities in the dirt. What will happen is when that leaves a space in the sediment, they are actually very porous, and water seeps in, and the minerals that the water leaves behind creates these beautiful crystals. Now there's two different crystals. There is a quartz crystal and there is a silica crystal. Quartz crystals are most commonly formed in volcanic geodes. Silica crystals are most commonly formed in sedimentary geodes. And no, this is not knowledge that I've had previously. This is knowledge that I just learned about just so I could make this video. But geodes have always, always interested me, and the formations that are made inside them are really cool. And today we're gonna find us a nice one and we're gonna bust it open. Now, these are very, very unassuming rocks on the outside, but it's what's on the inside that's very interesting. So let's go find one. Now, just now, walking up this hill, I found one on the ground here. Here's one that's partially been busted open already. You can see the crystals there. Very neat looking. Here's another one here on the ground. It's a smaller one. It's been busted open as well. So let's keep looking. I've been up this hill before and I don't remember it being this steep. It is pretty steep. As many people have said, there's no true original idea. So this idea here for me to come do this is not original either. I was watching Yankee's Outdoor Adventures the other day. If you don't know who he is, I will leave a card right here. Go check him out. He's got a great channel, great community, great supporter. He's a good dude. But he was busting open a geode on his channel. And I said to myself, Ben, that's a pretty good idea. So that's why we're out here. Thank you.
creek bed. Actually, it's just a wash. You can see it goes up the hill there. Big wash all the way up the hill. And there's some down here in the bed of this little wash area. You can see there's a small one here. It's got cracks in it. Been busted a little bit. There's one laying here. Just looks like all the rest of them. It's been broken. They're usually circular, all the way circular. Here's another one over here. It's been cracked. You can see some of the crystals there. I found a really great one here. It's already busted. But look at all the crystals on the end of that. That is pretty amazing. Lots of crystals on that one. Then you'll get these very, very small ones. That probably doesn't have any kind of cavity in it at all. It's a very small geode. See it in my hand? There's another one. Very small geode. Here's a part of one that's been busted. Well. And part of a really big one, looks like, that's been busted open. That would be the outside of it. Just a sliver. But there is all the crystals. Look at that, that is beautiful. So I just came up to this big ash tree. Yes, calm down people, I said big ash. Not what you think I said. Hollowed out spot at the bottom. The geode right here. That's been busted a little. Yep, it's been busted up pretty good. A little bit of snow left over from, day before yesterday. It's pretty cool though, it's a giant tree. And another small one. Can you see it? Right there. A little bitty tiny one. They're all over this hillside, but most of the big ones I'm finding are already busted. Perfect, perfect, perfect. There's a spot here I want you to see. Oh, and by the way, look at the view. Amazing. Well, trip cut short. My little stinker Blair's over at her aunt's house, and she just called me and needs me to come get her. So I'm headed out of here. Back down the car, I'm gonna go get a little poopsie. Plus my nose is starting to run. My nose is cold. My fingers are cold. And I just found a big geode. Look at that, that's pretty cool. That's pretty neat right there. Of course it's been busted. We can't find one that's solid. Oh, I just found a big one. Look at there, it's a big geode. Wow, that's pretty big. It's been here a while, got some moss on it. That is a big geode. I'll just leave it there and let it be. Beautiful rock.
I think there's been some deer here. What do you think? Looks like Cocoa Puffs. Let me tell you, going down this hill is much easier than going up it. That's the way it usually is, especially for a middle-aged guy that's a little bit overweight. But thanks for joining me today on this hike. I hope you enjoyed the little bit that I could give you about geodes. Hope you learned a little bit about those neat rock formations. There's not very many places in the world that they form, but this is one of the places that they do. So I just wanted to take you along, show you how cool they were, and we will see you next time. But until next time, get out there and enjoy the outdoors.